Greetings. Let's get back to 3B of the combat kit. It seems rather mundane for Deedat to be ridiculing Abraham, saying that Sarah is his sister. And Sarah was, in fact, half-sister to Abraham. She is the daughter of Abraham's father, Terah, Genesis 20:10. Abimelech also asked Abraham, "What were you thinking when you did this?" Abraham said, "I thought that because there were no God-fearing people in this place, I'd be killed because of my wife. Besides, she is my sister, my father's daughter, but not my mother's. She is also my wife. When God had me leave my father's home and travel around, I said to her, 'Do me a favor. Wherever we go, say that I'm your brother.'" So you can see Sarah was the half-sister of Abraham. And you can see Abraham's fear that made him lie to protect himself. And what that proves is that Abraham was human. And that God makes covenants even if we humans are not perfect. And the reason I am pointing that out is because Islam tries to claim God's eternal covenant with Abraham has somehow ended. But if you are paying attention, you have noticed God did not base his covenant on Abraham's perfection. For indeed, Abraham was not perfect. Let's continue with 3b. Because having mocked Abraham for his marriage to his sister, which God blessed, Deedat then has the unmitigated stupidity to claim Hagar the slave girl was Abraham's wife. Genesis 20:12, "Hagar, Abraham's wife! And she, Sarah, gave her Hagar to her husband to be his wife," Genesis 16:3. And this really is one of those hot buttons for Mohammedans, even those who are not Arab. Let's take a look at the text after I give you three things to keep in mind. We need to look at Abraham's behavior. Did Abraham ever call Hagar his wife? We just saw that talking to Abimelech, he did say, "Sarah is my wife." We need to look at the context of why Sarah did what she did. And we need to respect the teaching of the Bible on this matter. Genesis 16:1. "Now Sarah, Abram's wife, bare him no children, and she had a handmaid, an Egyptian whose name was Hagar. So she said to Abram, 'The Lord has kept me from having children. Go, sleep with my maidservant. Perhaps I can build a family through her.' Abraham agreed to what Sarah said." This is very important context to pay attention to. Notice what Sarah says to Abraham. "Go, sleep with my maidservant. Perhaps I can build a family through her." Sarah wants to use her slave as a surrogate womb. Sarah said, "Perhaps I can build a family through her." Sarah is still thinking this is her family, Sarah's family, Sarah's children, Sarah's husband. "Go sleep with my maidservant. Perhaps I can build a family through her." Notice Sarah does not say, "Sleep with your new wife." Sarah says, "Sleep with my maidservant." Sarah still claims ownership. And Abraham agrees to do what Sarah said. So after Abram had lived 10 years in the land of Canaan, Sarah, Abram's wife, took Hagar the Egyptian, her servant, and gave her to Abraham, her husband, as a wife. And that phrase is the phrase Islam and Deedat try to claim as proof of something, as a wife. But as I have mentioned, look how Abraham treats her and calls her. He slept with Hagar, and she became pregnant. When Hagar realized that she was pregnant, she began to be disrespectful to Sarah, her owner. Notice Sarah is still her owner, not Abraham's first wife, as you would count if you were a second wife. Then Sarah said to Abram, "You are responsible for the wrong I am suffering. I put my servant in your arms, And now that she knows she is pregnant, she despises me. May the Lord judge between you and me. Notice, I put my servant in your arms. Not, I made her your second wife. But Abram said to Sarah, behold, your maid is in your power. Do to her what is good in your sight. So Sarah treated her harshly, and she, Hagar, fled from Sarah's presence. Your maid is in your power. Not, she is my wife too, work it out. In fact, he makes no claim. She is your maid. Don't you think it a bit cold to say that if she is your wife, carrying your only child? Clearly, in Abraham's mind, Hagar was not his wife. Did Abraham ever call Hagar his wife? No, he did not. Not once did Abraham call Hagar his wife. Two, we need to look at the context of why Sarah did what she did. Sarah was barren and past the time of her monthly cycle. Sarah saw a way she thought would make it happen. We need to respect the teaching of the Bible on this matter. It is all about respecting the Word of God, the Torah, which Moses revealed. It does not matter if you want to push your own agenda. The Torah clearly reveals Hagar was never the wife of Abraham. But I will not insult Hagar. She was a slave and had no rights to say no. Just as in Muslim countries to this day, slave girls are raped by their masters. And one more aspect to consider. Does Hagar ever call Abraham her husband? Genesis 16:7. The angel of the Lord found Hagar near a spring in the desert. It was the spring that is beside the road to Shur. The angel said to her, Hagar, Sarah's servant, where have you come from and where are you going? I'm running away from my mistress, Sarah, she replied. The angel does not say, Hagar, wife of Abraham, but says, Hagar, Sarah's servant. And I thought Mohammedans believed what angels said. I'm running away from my mistress, Sarah, she replied. Still very clear that Hagar was slave to Sarah. The messenger of the Lord said to her, go back to your owner and place yourself under her authority. Wow, this angel just does not let up. Go back to your owner, and submit to her. He doesn't even say submit to Allah. Not go back to your husband. He will protect you. You would think the angel, the messenger of Allah, would know if Hagar was a wife or not. You can keep reading if you want more about Hagar and Ishmael. The next three verses may be described as a mixed blessing and curse. Ishmael would grow in numbers to become a great nation, but he also will be a wild donkey, a jackass of a man. He will fight with everyone, and everyone will fight with him. He will have conflicts with all of his relatives. Did God nail that one, or what? So that is the text of the Torah if Deedat had wanted to read it and learn the truth. Why do you think Deedat ignored the text of the Torah? Deedat had an agenda. Hagar, Abraham's wife. And his agenda is all about giving Muhammad credentials, continuing the desperate mission to support that Muhammad has some right or claim to the covenant of Isaac. In conjunction with that, Islam will continue their other stratagem, hoping to wipe every last Jew off the face of the planet. Then they think, at long last, they will supplant Isaac and possess the covenant. But that does not show any respect for Almighty God. It does not respect the Torah which God sent. And remember, a central deception of Islam is their claim to respect the Torah and Moses and the God they revealed. But what does this mean for you, O Mohammedans, if Hagar was not Abraham's wife? Well, it means there is not covenant relationship existing through Ishmael. But this is not a video about Ishmael. Instead, it is about refuting the lies of Deedat's Combat Kit. And you will believe the lies you want to believe. Or you may respect the truth I have just shown you. Hagar was not Abraham's wife, and it is a willful lie to make the claim when Deedat has no evidence to support it. I continue to be amazed that those who claim to submit to Al-Haq tolerate lies and deception. It is up to you, brother, whether you want to receive the love of the truth or not. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.